Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Nalin, and I'm your friend. No titles, no surname, no designations. I'm your friend. And I'm very happy to be here. Thank you very much, first of all, for inviting me and giving me the opportunity to share my thoughts. My topic is communicating to connect. I feel excited to talk about this because it is a life-changing subject. Communicating to connect. Mr. Khimji was just talking about communication and the importance of communication. And before I start, I would like to give just one tip. I used to work for Walmart for some time, and we used to have a sundown rule, which states that any communication, any email that comes to you, by sundown you have to respond to the person. You may not have the answer, but you can tell him that, yeah, I've received your email, give me 3 days' time, give me 1 week's time, give me 2 weeks' time, and I'll come back. So the person knows that you have received the email, you have received the communication, and it's not waiting in the unknown, so understand that. So thank you very much. So talking about communication and the, if you see what holds you from success or where you are and what will take you to greater success, there are so many things. We can talk about knowledge. We can talk about your skills. We can talk about talent. We can talk about experience. But these you may have, but still you may not be successful. What makes you successful is the ability to connect with people. You may be the most intelligent person, but who cares? You may have all the skills you need, but who cares? Until you are able to communicate. We are all emotional human beings. We are not machines. We need to connect with each other. We need to touch the hearts of people before we can move forward and before we can succeed. Imagine if connecting was simple, entering into a phone conversation. When we are speaking to someone on the phone, and if the line gets disconnected, we know that we've lost the person. Yeah? But it doesn't happen in the physical scenario. We may be talking to somebody, but people might have lost the interest in our conversation. Yeah? But we don't get that. That's a drawback. That we don't know when the disconnection happens. And then when disconnection happens, it's as good as not being there. You may be physically present, but you're not being there. So that's the importance of connection. There's a story that I would like to share, one of my favorite on connection. It's about a bank robber called Rodriguez in early 1900s in Mexico. So this guy used to slip into the Texas border on the US side, and he used to rob the banks, and his techniques were so expert that the police was not able to catch hold of him. So a special task force was constituted, and they finally reached out, and one night when he was sitting in the restaurant, the police was caught in. The police officer knew English but didn't know Spanish. The robber knew Spanish but did not know English. So the policeman takes out the gun and puts it on the robber's head and speaks something in English, threatens him. The robber speaks something in Spanish, nobody understands. There's a young boy in the crowd, he comes over and offers to help. Sir, I know English, I know Spanish. So the policeman says, tell him that if he doesn't return each and every dollar that he has stolen, I'm going to blow his brains off. The robber tells to the young boy that I've not spent even a single dollar. Tell the policeman it is lying at this address, and take the money and leave me. The boy says, Mr. Policeman, he says he's a brave man and he's ready to die. So, because they couldn't connect, both were communicating. Communication is so simple. We communicate, we speak words, we write text, but until we connect, nothing happens. So that's the power of communication. How many of you have had chances that you've spoken to somebody but you've felt you've not been able to connect with that person? Anybody? Is that person sitting next to you now? Yes. Yeah, but it's all, I mean, it's nothing, I'm not talking about anything which you've not heard about before. Connection is so key. In our daily interaction with people, we connect. Whether it is our family, our friends, office, work relationships, wherever. Yeah? So connecting is about increasing our influence, because connecting helps us. Connecting is a very key leadership skill. And leadership is nothing but increasing your influence. Whether it is your promotion or your career advancement, you're working for an organization. If you're looking for promotion, you need to connect with your family and friends. Why do we have divorce cases? Why do we have relationship problems? Because we're not able to connect. Business owners and entrepreneurs, we need to connect. If we are able to lead the teams properly to the desired results that we want, whether it is an employee who wants to add value to the team, to the boss, needs to connect with the boss, understand the expectations. The manager, for him to lead the team, needs to connect with the team. So that's the power of connecting, and that's the importance of connecting. How many of you here want to improve your results? Nobody wants to improve their results. Actually, yes, all of us. But even those who didn't raise their hand, if they were honest enough, they would also say yes. Because each one of us want to improve. We are not happy in what we are. We have to grow further. We have to improve. Whether it is more money for somebody, whether it is more time, a better relationship, but we need to improve. And that's the only thing that can help us improve is the power of communication, the power of connection. Because, as I said, we are emotional human beings. We don't work in isolation. We work with people. And connecting is all about others. Forget your ego. Because if we are thinking of connecting and we are only thinking about ourselves, then we are not doing anything to connect. You have to value others. Until you think about others, you will not be able to connect with them. Forget your arrogance. You may be right. In an argument, you may be right. But after winning an argument, in 100% of the situations, are you happy? You may have a big fight with your spouse and you prove your point right. But in the evening, if you're sitting in one corner and your spouse in the other corner, did you really win that argument? You may sit with your boss, prove your point, prove your boss wrong. You have that emotional satisfaction, but for how long? Ultimately, are you happy? So winning an argument is not always a sign of happiness. So leave the arrogance. I'm not saying that you, even if you're right, you take the mistake of you. But there are situations where we are all human beings. We understand what I'm saying, right? Value others. I'll give you another short story about Warren Buffett. A newspaper correspondent was trying to get an appointment with him for many months. She couldn't get it. Finally, she could get 10 minutes. The next day, when the 10 minutes were scheduled, she did some research and found out that Warren Buffett holds a large stockholding in Coca-Cola company. And his favorite beverage was Cherry Coke. So she had the Cherry Coke ready. And when the meeting started, she said, "Mr. Buffett, before we start the discussion, would you like to start with your favorite beverage, Cherry Coke?" He said, "Good lady, nobody has started the interview like this before. You can have all the time you want." So that's the power of communication and connecting. And she actually spent an hour and a half with one another because she could connect. And communication is not merely the wording and the message. Whatever you say has little value because the words I am speaking might have a different effect on you. If I write it down on a piece of paper and you read it, it may have a different effect on you. If you pass that piece of paper to somebody else who has not attended this session, might see it differently. So words really don't matter altogether. Because communication is words, tone of voice, and body language. What we say is only 7% of what is believed. The way we say it accounts for 38%. And what others see accounts for 55%. So 93% of what we say or what we communicate is actually nonverbal. It's my tone of voice and the body language. Only 7% is the words that matter. And these are studies, these are psychological studies that has given these results. Again, as I said, we are emotional human beings. We see things as we are, not the world the way the world is. Now, if you see this picture, what do you see? Take 5 seconds. What do you see? same depth of water. For one person it's deep, for one person it is not. Same fish in the aquarium, for one person it's an object of curiosity, and for one it's tonight's dinner. So this is the perspective. We all have different beliefs, different values, different perspective on life, different passions, different milestones to achieve, different priorities, different assessment of relationships. We are all different, we are all unique human beings. There's no set pattern, but connecting is universal. The connectors may be different. How you connect with somebody, you may have a difficult boss, I don't know how you're going to impress him, but you might, I mean, you need to look at the relationship, the personality of the person and come up with what impresses your boss, or what impresses your spouse, or what is liked by your children. Your wife is fond of flowers, so every day if you take a bouquet of flowers, she might be happy and maybe you're able to connect. But if she feels that you're wasting time, 10 riyals every day, money, 10 riyals every day on the bouquet, that may not be a good way of connecting. So you have to see, but ultimately what boils down is that connection is important. How you connect, you have to see each relationship. And connecting always requires energy. This is so important because if you are not taking that initiative to go to people and connect, nobody is going to come to you. You have to take that first step. You have to take that initiative. You have to be the first to help. Have patience. People may not always be good with you. Have patience. Be a good listener. That's another important aspect that we should understand. We sometimes just keep on speaking. We put on our word and then chapter closed. Be a good listener. Ideas come from the other person as well. You were not made the most intelligent person on earth. There are other people as well. Ask questions. Ask intelligent questions so that the conversation triggers. Conversation triggers leads to new ideas. New ideas lead to growth of yourself and the other person. Be humble. Obviously, that is a key human trait that we should always be humble. What's there in arrogance? What's there in arrogance? And reach out to people. Again, a Walmart example. We have a 10-foot rule in Walmart. So whenever you enter a Walmart store, and if there is a customer within 10 feet of the employee is supposed to approach the customer and ask politely, how can I help you? So Walmart does a lot of these things, like the sundown rule, the 10-foot rule. They have a lot of these kind of things. And these are things intended to connect with people. That's the reason they are the world's number one retailer. Be interesting, obviously. If I'm talking here and nobody is enjoying what I'm saying, then there's no point. I mean, I'm myself a work in progress and I'm trying to connect with you people. I don't know if I was successful in connecting. But yeah, so you have to be interesting. Yeah. You'll find some people which are boring, and for most people, life is boring. So see what you can do to make that conversation interesting. What anecdotes, what humor you can build in the conversation so that it helps you connect. Starting a meeting, maybe if you ask the person, how's your family doing, how are the children doing, all well, maybe it sets the stage on a different tone and you probably get that contract from the customer. Feeling appreciated brings out the best in people. Thank people. We are not a one-man army to do everything in the world. We need teams, we need people. Thank people for the contribution that they have made to your lives. That will go a long way in building connection. So, I didn't have a long presentation, but I would like to understand, did you find this interesting or enjoyable or no? Interesting. Yes. That's the beauty of it, that it is interesting, but it doesn't have the impact. Because we say change is not an event, it's a process. Why? Because we come here, we attend leadership conferences, we attend seminars, we go to conferences, training programs, and then when we go back, we don't act on it. No conference, no program, no leadership training will help you if you don't want to help yourself. So unless we apply those things in our daily lives, unless we work on it, unless we are intentional about improving ourselves, nothing is going to change. These programs will make their money and then go on. It's on us to derive value from that. So we have a tendency to overestimate the events and a tendency to underestimate the process. We think we've attended the event, that's the best leadership conference available in the world. I've attended a 1 week program, I'm the best now. That's probably the biggest mistake that we do. Thank you very much.